folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on connecting to MinIO using the Go language. And in this video, we're using Go version 1.19. We're going to be connecting out to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can connect to the MinIO platform. And we're going to be doing all this out of Visual Studio Code. A brief little agenda on what we're going to be looking at. We're going to show you how to set up your Go environment so that you can actually initialize the MinIO client and connect to our play.min.io environment. Let's take a look at some code. So here I've got a very simple little demo Go package. And the key here is that when you're setting up your Go environment, there's a couple of steps you need to take. Obviously, one of the first things you're going to want to do here is do this Go mod init. And I've already done a Go mod init. And my Go mod is setting up a MinIO demo mod. And I'm using Go 1.19. Now, the rest of this all comes from the process of doing a Go get. And what I'm going to do is this go get on github.com minio, minio-go v7. This actual first version here, this requirement that I have, I can actually just copy it. Obviously, I've already done this once, but let me just show you go get. And when you run that, it's actually going to go out and get everything for you. You'll see a lot more output when you're doing yours. It's going to download a bunch of different Go libraries that you're going to be able to use. So let's go ahead back to our demo Go. And what I'm doing here is I've imported a context, a format, a log. This is all some basic stuff that I need to use when I'm going to do some networking, going to show some stuff off. But then I've also imported these custom github.com MinIO libraries so that I can actually work with all of this. So what I'm doing here in my main function is I've set up an endpoint, an access key, and a secret key. And then I'm also setting up a variable for useSSL being true. These are all strings except for useSSL, which is a Boolean. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to initialize my MinIO client. And to do this, I call minio.new right here on line 19. And minio.new takes both an endpoint and then a list of options. The options include some credentials. There's a secure, there's a transport you can use, a region. But at our level, all we're really doing is we're going to use the creds and the secure, which I have already defined some variables for. Credentials, by the way, is part of minio's tool. So it is a custom credentials object that we're working with here. And when we use this MinIO credentials, we're giving it the access key, the secret key. That's our username password. This access key and secret key, by the way, is common for all of play.min.io. So if you're connecting out to play.min.io, you can use this exact access key, secret key to connect to it, and you'll have full control of the system. Basically, you can do anything you like. So once I'm actually connected out there, I'm going to get a list of buckets. And then I'm just going to print the total number of buckets out here. So in a lot of cases, I'm using that log to record an error. If I have an error, in my case, I'm not going to really have any. But that's everything that I need to know. So I'm connecting to play.min.io. I've got my access key, secret key. We're going to go ahead and run this. So I can do just a go run. I can do a go run dot. I could do a go run demo dot go. Either way, works, because this is my main class. And I've got 149 buckets out there on play.min.io right now. And that's everything you need to know about connecting to MinIO using Go. Hope you've enjoyed this little how-to. If you'd like to connect with us, you can connect with us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can always chat with us interactively on minio.slack.com, or of course, just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.